Okay, so let's go back here. It's pretty easy to get rid of the differential mode emission. Why is it easy? Because we can control the size of the loop. As I said, differential mode is coming out of this loop. So yeah, then let's make the loop very small as possible. Then there is not that much differential mode. Also for the cables, we can twist the cables in a twisted way so that the differential mode emission is somehow canceling. But for the common mode emission, any idea how we can get rid of the common mode emission? Yeah, the length of the cable is definitely a very important thing. We use short cables because the cable, as I mentioned, is acting as a transmitting antenna. If the transmitting antenna is not that effective, the electromagnetic emission that is generated is also not that good. But very often we have to handle this common mode problem there where it's generated. And there is a reason why I have drawn this printed circuit board in this stupid way, cable red, cable at the right-hand side, cable at the left-hand side. Because now I think you step by step get the point. Where is an example? Here, very good example. So what is this? Basically the same thing as we have here, with the difference that here we are not providing 12 volt DC, we are providing 230 volt AC, but here it comes out whatever 18 volt DC, so it's a kind of switch mode power supply. So you can imagine there's nothing else as this thing here. And how is it designed? Cable left, cable right. This is a very good transmitter of electromagnetic emission and energy. That is the reason why some switched mode power supplies, they have these ferrite clamps, beads here and here. This is exactly to get rid of common mode currents. So this is the most, I wouldn't say a stupid way, but it's not the ideal way to design a printed circuit board, especially not related to the location of the connectors. Because as I mentioned, ground cable here, ground cable there, voltage drop between the ground points generating common mode emissions. So much better would it be if the designer of the printed circuit board would have used this connector and placed it all over there to this connector next to each other. And then also place the ground wires close to each other. Then the difference between the two ground connections on the ground plane is not that big. There is still a voltage drop, but it's somewhere else, not where the cable is located. So a better way to design a printed circuit board. And this is also IC design. So every design guideline that I'm talking about on printed circuit board design can be somehow reused for the IC design. Because it also doesn't make sense to design an IC where we have an input here with a ground connection and an input there where we have a ground connection. And there are many old designs where we have mixed signal designs. We have an analog part and a digital part. And then they have an analog ground pin and a digital ground pin. They're not connected, the ground domains with each other, which is not that good. Because inside of the chip, they are connected anyway by the substrate, for example. Okay, so step by step, I would like to give you some ideas and design guidelines how to make better designs. Yeah, coming back to the question, what can we do in order to avoid common mode currents? For differential mode currents, okay, make the loop small, twist the cables, keep the cables as close as possible. For the common mode currents, okay, place the connectors not that far away next to each other. Any other ideas?
Common mode filtering.
Exactly, common mode filtering. So there is a so-called common mode choke. What's wrong with my beamer? There is a common mode choke that we can place on one of the cables. Usually it's not needed to place it on this cable and on that cable because the common mode current that flows, as mentioned, is anyway on both cables. So we can place the common mode choke here or there. In my design, if this is the input and this is the output, I would place the common mode choke at not just somewhere. I would place it. Any idea where I would place it? Here, at the input or at the output? From the EMC perspective, doesn't matter. So we have to place a common mode choke either here or there. Okay. Okay, very good point. Yeah. Where would you place it? Yeah, me too. So I would place it at the output. Why? Because there is not that much current flowing. So we have a boost converter. Usually it's half the current, avoiding all the losses, nearly half the current at the output. So therefore, usually the dimension of the common mode current, common mode choke can be smaller, because if there is not that much current flowing, the common mode choke doesn't go that fast in saturation, and we can use maybe a common mode choke which is a little bit smaller from the dimensions point of view. Can be an advantage. But from the EMC point of view, it doesn't matter if it's here or there. It's just a cost point of view and a saturation point of view or whatever.